Hi, this is Victor Gamov with Confluent, and in this lesson, I will show you how you can use Kafka Listener to receive new messages from Kafka Topic and Confluent Cloud. Let's get to it. In the previous lesson, you learned how you can send new messages into Kafka Topic, and we used Confluent Cloud UI to consume those messages. And this is the time where you learn how you can do this programmatically using Spring Boot and Spring Kafka. Let's create a new class called Consumer. In this class, we will have some method called public void a consume, and in this method we need to do something with this data. So we can say it's going to be string quote, and in this case I will do Kafka listener annotation here. I need to specify what's the topic. In our case, it will be Hobbit. You can subscribe to multiple topics, as you know. Group ID is important, and the property that we need to specify, Spring Boot Kafka. Now, in order to do something with this quote, we will just do let's call it. We need to make this as a component. We're good to go. Also, we need to tell default deserializer what kind of data is coming into our application. So in this case, we can do Kafka consumer value deserializer. And in this case, we're going to be using org Apache Kafka common serialization string deserializer. And so we not forget about the key deserializer as well. So we go in Kafka consumer key deserializer, and we need to specify it org Apache Kafka common serialization and integer deserializer, since we have a data in format an integer for key and the string for our value. I need to specify those deserializers here. In the future lessons, I'll show you how we can use more complex types and how we can use schemas to with this application, and how you can configure your application to use all these nice things. Now, in my consumer is ready to roll, I need to go and restart my application. Take some time to compile this. Application is up and running. And now we start seeing all these new messages arriving in this console. So let's take a look. What do we see in Confluent Cloud? In the Confluent Cloud, we can go to this left side menu and find the consumers. Sometimes it will take some time to refresh, so it's always good to refresh it. And now we see the same group that I specified in my code over here, saying that it is going to be Spring Boot Kafka. I see this consumer group is consuming all partitions, all six partitions in my topic. And I can see offsets, I can see consumer lag here, all these nice things. And also, if I go to this Hobbit topic, I will be able to see different dependencies or different applications that connected to this topic. In this particular case, that's my consumer application, custom app, and that's my producer application, also custom app. So essentially, in my application configuration, in my Spring Boot application configuration, I will be able to change this. By default, producer one is the default client ID. You can change this in Spring Boot application, like here, and you can go and say producer client ID, I can say Spring Boot producer. Also, if you're interested in your application, if you're interested to getting also information about the keys, you can do that as well. And let me show you how you can do that. So let me stop this application real quick. I'm getting back to my code. And instead of right now, instead of string, instead of value, I actually can inject here and consumer record. And in this case, my consumer record will be key is an integer. And my value is a string, and I can say record, and I can say this dot value, and something like plus with key record dot key. So now, if I run this application once again, we should be able to get access to record key. As you can see here, all these new messages start arriving with this updated information. My consumer is again up and running, and we will be able to see what this consumer does. Now you know how you can consume messages from Confluent Cloud using Spring Boot and Kafka Listener.